随着政治两极化，种族和社会阶级分化扩大，仇恨犯罪事件不断增加，应如何定义仇恨犯罪行为及如何遏制？8月19日，少数族裔媒体服务机构 EMS 举行每周网络列会，邀请了多位专家探讨如何界定和治理美国日趋严重的种族仇恨的犯罪行为。加州公民权益部副主任 Becky Monroe 表示，为了遏制日趋严重仇恨犯罪，加州民权部也正在建立一个机构，希望能打击仇恨犯罪，为潜在受害者提供保护。据他解释，仇恨案例分为两种，第一种指的是侵害和违反民权法律的行为，例如就业和住房歧视，第二种指的是并未违反法律但对社区和个人造成伤害的行为，民众都需要认知和重视。
Are we listening to the communities who are targeted for hate? Have we heard from those vendors or their families? If we are not listening to them, then you are absolutely right. We may miss the fact that there was an hate incident or a hate crime attack there. So that's part of what I talk about when I'm talking about reporting. I am not only talking about reporting for the purposes of prosecution. I am talking about reporting so we have a better understanding of the risks that people face when they're just trying to go to work.
在过去两年中 ，Stop AAPI Hate 总共收到了10905起仇恨事件报告，其中 48.7% 发生在公园和街道中， 26.9% 发生在商业和企业场所。此外，女性受害者占比 61.8%， 大多数事件都是言语骚扰 63% 和人身攻击 16.2%， 还有一些是来自于网络的骚扰。从族裔来分，华人是首要攻击对象，占仇恨事件的 40%， 韩裔和菲律宾裔分别占 16.1% 和 8.9%。
As I said before, most of these are hate incidents and not hate crimes, and so that really should encourage us to know and understand that a one-size-fits-all solution does not work, and that policing is not going to be the answer to all of our problems here.
种族歧视是植根于美国的顽疾，而由此延伸出来的针对少数族裔仇恨犯罪，近年来更是成倍的增长，已经成为美国社会关注的焦点，也是少数族裔媒体需要持续报道的热点新闻。对此，少数族裔媒体服务机构 EMS 多次召开网络会议进行研讨，该机构负责人表示将继续关注在美少数族裔的合法权益。全美电视台记者洛杉矶采访报道。